G'day there, Pete Moriarty here. I have another question to answer for Rebecca. And Rebecca asks, is it best to put all my files just in the cloud in Google Drive's web interface, or should I synchronize them down to my computer? Stemming from the 90s when we got our first email address and we wanted to like conserve space by deleting the spam emails in our inbox, because if we got too many emails, it would fill up and you know, we'd start getting bounce backs and stuff. Or, you know, I think about like the Microsoft Outlook days, where if you got too many emails in your local data file, it would fill up. And then once it was full, Search would stop working, Outlook would start crashing, and you'd start having all those kind of problems. Based on those historical events, we still have the mentality in our mind that we need to keep our digital spaces clean. Now, it's certainly still important to not fill up your hard drive on your computer, but I really have the mentality, and I try and instill this in our customers as much as possible, to just treat digital storage as unlimited. If you're on G Suite and you subscribe to the business plan, you get unlimited storage. And it's not unlimited with a fair play policy, it's literally unlimited. I personally have terabytes and terabytes of 4K drone footage, all kinds of stuff stored inside my Google Drive, and it never slows down. Google never complains about how much data I've got in there, and it all works brilliantly. So if you're still thinking, hey, I should keep my digital spaces clean, then don't worry about that. Just make good use of all of Google's effectively infinite storage. Now, to specifically answer the question of should I keep files on my computer or should I have them all on the cloud? Well, Google makes it very easy with an application called Google Drive File Stream. And Google File Stream is an app that sits on your computer. It's similar to the Google Drive Sync app that Google have now rebranded and rebuilt into File Stream. Now, it works the same kind of way as the Google Drive app did or that Dropbox did, but with a few special features. So with the old Google Drive app or with the Dropbox app, you've got to kind of choose what folders do I want to have local and what folders do I want to have up on the web. And you've got to kind of manage that data and think about it yourself. Whereas FileStream does all of this automatically and it does it really well. So what does Google FileStream do? Well, it takes each one of your files that you've got in your Google Drive online and it lets you see them all from the local desktop. So you're looking at the cloud, but you're actually browsing on the local desktop. So if you're on a Mac or you're on a PC or you're on a Chromebook, you see your whole Google Drive and you see all of your team drives as well. While you can see all those files, if you go to open one of them, Google actually downloads it in the background. So it's not actually stored on your machine until you click open and it goes to open that file. And Google's got some AI smarts in there, so they're gonna automatically download the files in the background when you've recently used them. It also predicts what files you might wanna use in the future, and it keeps a copy of the last few files that you used just on your machine, just in case you wanna open them again. So if you happen to, for say, be offline and you wanna get access to one of those files again, Google makes it really easy for you to just click through via Google File Stream and you can access the file. Now you may ask, well, what if I'm completely offline? If you're completely offline and you want access to a certain folder or a certain file using Google File Stream, you just right click on that file and then you say, I want to keep this file offline. And that keeps either the file or the folder offline and synchronized down to your computer. Now, if you've got a bunch of files and you want to upload them to the cloud or drop them into your Google Drive, you can drag and drop it into File Stream. Google's going to upload all of those so they're stored on Google Drive online, and then it does its little cleanup and it removes them locally. So should I have them online or offline? It doesn't really matter. They're all secured by your Google account. Once files are on the computer, you're able to access them anytime you need. But FileStream really takes out the guessing game that you used to have to do with the old Google Drive app, or you still have to do with the Dropbox app of ticking or unticking, you know, the selective sync of, do I want this file on or off? It's all a manual process, whereas FileStream just uses AI to automate all of that. So think about when you might need those files. If you're gonna need them offline, you might select a certain folder or file structure to stay offline. Otherwise, personally, I tend to just leave most things online, but I still definitely use Google File Stream so I can access them easily. Anyway, if you need any help with File Stream, Google Drive, rolling it out, setting up permissions, or just doing an audit to check on how you've got things set up, get in touch with our team, itgenius.com, or you can message us on Facebook. And until next time, I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.